change is coming to Britain. A new model for our nation is about to be forged. 40 years as part of the Star-Spangled Circle is over. No more laws made in Brussels, an end in free movement of people, and the Prime Minister's plans include pulling Britain out of the single market, potentially discarding the ability to buy and sell whatever we like to and from the continent. Britain will refashion itself in a Brexit age, a new relationship with Europe, and new trade deals with the rest of the world. Our journey out of the EU is about to begin. First, a quick stop with former Cabinet Minister Peter Lilly. He helped make the single market, but is only too pleased to be leaving it.
I am, and I'm not one of those who thinks we'll automatically get a free trade deal. There's quite a big chance that we won't, but even so, we'll be better off. They probably won't, or quite possibly won't want one, because they want to frighten off their own voters to stop them voting for Eurosceptic parties, and they'll just mean that we'll be enjoy a few less benefits than we get if we had a free trade deal.
But in his constituency, do they agree? Unlike Peter Lilly, Harpenden voted Remain by 65%.
Well, I've come here to talk about Theresa's trade-off. How much of the single market are we going to give up to control our borders from the EU? And I've come to Harpenden's farmers market to see what the people here would prioritise.
I'd have the single market every time. No trade barriers suits us nicely. We need the immigrants to help run the country, actually, frankly.
I think I'd control the borders myself.
If I was much younger and starting off in life, I'd probably vote the other way.
Why should we not be able to have free movement of people and goods, and also, you know, have some control on who comes and goes? I mean, it's you know, why can't you have a bit of both?
You effectively want to have your sausage sandwich and eat it, basically.
Why not?
With these tussles in Brussels that we're going to have, which one would you like Theresa May to focus on in the end if she has to?
Well, look, if I'm going to choose one or the other, I think probably single market.
If they are the only two options and you would like me to vote, I will vote for the full market
access. Okay.
Especially as that tries to diminish the immigration concerns.
Migration has been answered. We're all a bit frightened of it because there's just too many people smothering all countries, not just us, Europe as well. But we do need the free market. End of.
Do a good job, Theresa May.
Don't let us down.
Our future with the EU is far from black and white.
This morning I've spoken to 100 people here in Hertfordshire. 70% want Theresa May to get as much single market access as she possibly can, versus 30% who want her to control our borders, control the number of people coming from the EU.
Unlike North Hertfordshire, here in Bedfordshire they voted Leave. This high-end British manufacturer has been operating since the Industrial Revolution began. Heywood Tyler is reliant on the single market for its components. 70% come from the EU, but 85% of their finished goods are exported to non-EU countries. Overall, the plummeting pound caused by Brexit has had a positive effect, but the boss has concerns.
I think the frustration at the moment is just all the uncertainty created because, you know, there's a huge amount for us as a business that's now over 200 years old, that prides itself on the best of British engineering and the fact that we've always been open for business and we've always, in effect, exported our way into growth. You know, and now there's a lot of uncertainty created about, well, are we going to have tariffs in the future? How easy are we going to be as a country to do business with? And that could be used, you know, by our competition against us.
Round one of the road trip ends, with most people we've met so far having trade and market access as their Brexit priority. Tomorrow, Northamptonshire. Simon Dedman, BBC Look East.